Welcome to our Young Adults Deliverance Conference. There shall be deliverance here today in the name of Jesus Christ. And why we called this conference, I know youth and young adults, you are used to meeting in the park, doing outreach, and going to sight and sound. And those are great things, you know, those are great things. But we are in a time now where the needs are becoming so enormous. And the warfare is getting more intense.
Amen.
And I said, why should we go to a place like Sight and Sound or wherever you normally hang out when we can hang out in the presence of God and receive from God? So this is what informed this Young Adults Deliverance Conference. And this man of God has been in prayer, in fasting,
Jesus,
in the spirit for this day.
Amen.
And I must tell you, God has spoken to me. God has spoken to me concerning most of you. And it will become evident tonight.
Amen.
Let us go to the Bible, to the book of Jeremiah chapter 1. I want to show you something in Jeremiah chapter 1. Today we are talking about building. Building. What has that got to do with deliverance? In Jeremiah chapter 1, I start from verse 4. Then the word of the Lord came to me saying, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations. Then said I, ah, Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a youth. But the Lord said to me, do not say I am a youth, for you shall go to all to whom I send you, and whatever I command you, you shall speak. Do not be afraid of their faces, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Everybody say, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said to me, behold, I have put my words in your mouth. Still in Jeremiah chapter 1, let us jump to verse 19, the last verse. They will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you. For I am with you, says the Lord, to deliver you. I want us to catch verse 19. He says, they will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you. God did not say Jeremiah shall prevail. Look at verse 19. God did not say Jeremiah, you shall win the fight. All God said is that the enemy shall not win. God did not say to Jeremiah, you shall win. All God assured Jeremiah is, they shall not prevail against you. And God gives the reason why. He says, for I am with you, says the Lord, to deliver you. The Lord says he is with you to deliver you. Now let us jump to Matthew chapter 16. Matthew chapter 16. I will read for the sake of time. Verse 19. Matthew chapter 16. Let's go to verse 19. Let's start from verse 18. Let's start from verse 18. Matthew 16, I begin from verse 18. And I also say to you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church. Everybody say, build my church.
Build my church.
And the my church that Jesus is talking about is you and I. We are the church. Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. So Jesus says, on this rock, I will build my church. I will build you. You are the church. And I will say to you that you are Peter. And on this rock, I will build my church. And the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. I want you to catch something there. Just like what he told Jeremiah, he's saying to Peter, the gates of hell shall not prevail against my church. That does not mean the church will prevail against the gates of hell. I want you to catch that. Because a church that is lukewarm like the church in Laodicea will not prevail against the gates of hell. A church. So don't just assume that, I hear Christians say, upon this rock I shall build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. That is true, but that does not mean the church will prevail. He has not said the church will prevail here. It's going to take more than that for us to prevail. It's going to take warfare for us to prevail. And the gates of hate shall not prevail against it. So we are guaranteed that hell will not win. But there's no guarantee here that the church will win. None. In fact, there's one church in Revelation. He said, I'm about to spit you out of my mouth. So there's no guarantee. Don't say, we are the church and the gates of hell will not prevail. The gates of hell say, yeah, we know we won't prevail, but let's see you prevail. Amen. Let's see if you can prevail. Because Satan is happy with the stalemate. Stalemate means status quo remains the same. Nobody win. Verse 19. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. So you can bind a demon. That does not mean you have prevailed. It only means that the demon has not prevailed against you. And when it says the demon has not prevailed against you, what that means is that the demon has not seen his will accomplished against you. Am I making sense to somebody? But Jesus is the one building the church. And it says the gates of hell will not prevail. If the church allows Jesus to be the builder, if you allow Jesus to be the builder, you will prevail against the gates of hell. That's what I want you to catch. Now, when Jesus wants to build, somebody listen to me. You know, sometimes you see they want to build these skyscrapers in downtown Brooklyn. The first thing they do is they demolish what is there. They don't build on top of junk. Jesus is not going to build on top of junk. He will first demolish what is there. So Jesus is an expert at demolition and reconstruction. And so many of us, we want Jesus to build upon our mess. And Jesus said, no, I must first demolish it to pieces and clear out the debris. Then I start to build. Jesus will not build on top of what man has built, and he will not build on top of what Satan has built. He must first destroy, demolish it. And then he will start to build from scratch. And that's why some Christians have problems, because we tell them, check your foundation. Because they are building in Christ, but the foundation is something else. The foundation is not in Christ. I hope somebody is catching something here today. The Spirit of God is dropping some wisdom here. So you must allow Jesus to build. And remember, Jeremiah said, I'm only a youth. He gave an excuse. God is not interested in your excuse. When he says, I'm with you, it doesn't matter if you're an ant. He said, I'm only a youth. God says, I don't care if you're an ant. Even an ant, if I'm with an ant will defeat an elephant. And so what God wants to do here today, there's going to be a lot of demolition. There's going to be a lot of demolition, reconstruction, rearrangement. So that we can stand against the enemy. Some of you have not seen devil. So God wants to do a work today so that when that devil comes, that devil will be intimidated by you. I know how many demons have told me to stop what I'm doing. And if you want Jesus to build your house, it's going to come with a price. You're going to shed tears. But Jesus says, don't worry. Weeping endureth the night. Joy comes in the morning. And so Jesus is inviting you today to step out of your comfort zone. This is the word of God for this conference. Amen. I shut my Bible. The Bible says the kingdom of God is not about talk. So we didn't come here to talk. It's about the demonstration of the Spirit we're about to go to warfare prayers. We're going to pray some corporate prayers, and then we will do deliverance one-on-one.
Before I continue, my sister, what is your name? I forget your name.
Faith.
Faith. Faith, I must share this with you. You're not part of my sheep. You're not my sheep. You're in Times Square. Right, so your shepherd is in Times Square. This meeting is for my sheep. You're welcome to stay, but I cannot put my gravitas into you because I prayed concerning my sheep. And everything that God gave me is for my sheep. You're welcome to stay, but don't expect much because what I have inside me is for my sheep. You have a shepherd, your shepherd will feed you. Amen? We love you. That's not to say we don't love you, but I cannot do that in all our consciousness. So we're going to rise and we're going to pray. I want you to be involved. You're going to pray like you've never prayed before. You're going to pray like you've never prayed before.
Amen.
I want you to say after me, you're going to mean what you say and say what you mean. If you don't mean it, don't say it. Say, Heavenly Father,
in the name of Jesus,
I repent of all my sins, and I ask of your forgiveness tonight. Anything in me, or around me, or connected to me, that is not of God, I renounce you now. Come out by fire. In the name of Jesus. Whatsoever be in me that God did not plant, anything projected into me by powers of darkness, I command you in the name of Jesus, come out by fire now. Come out in the name of Jesus. Come out in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout.
Amen.
We're going to pray. Please pray after me. In the name of Jesus,
I renounce Satan
and all his works. In the name of Jesus, I renounce Satan and all his devices. In the name of Jesus, every satanic oppression against my life, be destroyed by fire. In the name of Jesus, satanic oppression, be destroyed by fire. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
We're still going to pray. We're still going to pray. Every strong man, assigned to frustrate me, tonight in the name of Jesus, I command you,
I overthrow you.
Come out of my life. You strong man, assigned against my destiny. I bind you tonight. Things are moving. Things are shifting. In the name of Jesus. Pastor, we don't forget to break it.
Yes.
Things are shifting. Things are moving. In the name of Jesus. We are still going to apply some pressure on the strong man. We are still going to apply some pressure on the strong man. Ancestral strong man.
Ancestral